I love to play the saxophone. I take it with me wherever I roam, and the sound of the saxophone always brings me home. I keep it with me every day, 'cause there's a song in my heart that I've got to play, and I feel it down deep in my soul. I love my saxophone. You can run around or you can jump off the stage, and I know with the saxophone that that's okay. You can sit, you can dance, you can rock, or you can stand and sway. Now what I do is press the first key down, take a deep breath and a good look around, and I blow in the horn and it makes a big, big sound.
Kitchen is actually, we're not here that often anymore. We used to be here all the time. You guys were with us all last year, but now we've been gone for like weeks, and this is the first week we've been home.
Okay, it's so fun to cook.
Woo!
When you've been out to restaurants at, like, every night on the road, and now we're home and we get to cook for you and for us.
How many people out there really just got real bored with all the things you were cooking, all the recipes? You were like, okay, we're going to make this for the 80th time during the pandemic. And we came home and we're like, oh my God, we have to cook. We haven't done it in so long.
I still had a request. I needed his Bolognese. His Bolognese is awesome. I married an Italian. If you haven't checked him out, he's got the olive skin. I don't have the olive skin, but he knows his wine, and he definitely knows how to make bolognese. So this was my request, that he make his bolognese, because I'm not sick of it. We have not been home at all. We've been on tour. I've been out with Summer Horns. I've been out with my band. We've done Burke's Jazz Festival, the Hollywood Bowl, a bunch of Florida dates. So we are headed to Northern California. This weekend we're playing Santa Barbara.
Woo!
I know, and Napa.
Yeah.
What? So, you know, I figured make him cook while we're home. And you know what? It's all actually, we blamed it on our wine is coming out today. So for all of our members, our Reserve Tastings Club members, our wines ship to you, what, is it tomorrow?
Yeah.
It's not today.
Tomorrow.
I'm thinking. It's tomorrow. So tomorrow, all of our wines go out, and it's Vive le Rock. That's what I'm talking about.
I'll show a picture from and, the Hollywood Bowl. There you go.
Yeah, from the Hollywood Bowl. And so you want to be a rock and roll star. So,
Sauvignon Blanc, Napa Valley, Rutherford, Not much better than that, baby.
No, they're amazing. So, our thought today, pair some bolognese made by my adorable, awesome cork dork husband.
Yep.
And I just get to sit back and watch him make it. And we get to drink our Cabernet Vive Le Rock and have some fun with you.
Yeah.
It's all dedicated to rock and roll because both of these labels are total rock and roll labels. And can I dedicate it?
Yeah.
Can I dedicate this? We lost Charlie Watts today.
Oh, yeah.
Charlie Watts.
Yeah.
The Rolling Stones. So.
He's not going to be drinking any more wine.
Cheers. Well, more for us. But.
Is that inappropriate?
It's maybe too soon.
Too soon.
Too soon.
Too soon.
I was going to say, too soon.
Only a couple hours? Too soon.
Inappropriate.
I'm a big Rolling Stone fan. As you know, I am the, you know, probably the president of their fan. No, I'm not. But I thought Charlie Watts looked old when I was a kid.
Oh, my God. He did.
He did. Okay. He was one of the ones. Like, whenever you see the pictures of the Stones, you have Charlie Watts, and he always looked like he was just, maybe he was just mellow. He was like the turtle, you know?
He was older than them,
wasn't he?
He was the old man,
we
right?
We made that up. Well, anyway.
Still, we don't want to lose him, and we love the Stones. So, cheers to the Stones.
Cheers to the Stones.
Charlie Watts, we love you. And
all right.
I'm going to play you some rock and roll later, but he's going to make you some rock and roll bolognese.
Well, what's the bolognese called?
Oh, it's like your bolognese.
It's Eric's awesome bolognese of awesomeness. Now, some of you guys know. Wait.
Eric's
awesome bolognese of awesomeness.
Awesome. So awesome is in there twice.
Well, I wanted to put it three times, but it wouldn't fit in the field.
You know, these are the conversations we have. Yeah. Okay, good.
And as many of you guys know, I'm actually half Italian. I got a lot of other things in me on the other side.
But you're what?
But I'm one side fully Italian. So I'm 100%, 50% Italian. That's good math, right?
Wow.
Wine math. And my family came over through Ellis Island, like many of yours. And I'm going to show you a picture right now. My brother did, during the pandemic, he did the, what do you call it? The, you know, the family
ancestry.
Tree. Ancestry. Yeah. Thank you. And we found people from way back. And I'm going to show you a picture right now of my great-grandfather and great-great-grandfather and grandmother.
Could
Ready?
They cook this bolognese, awesome bolognese of awesomeness?
They're all from northern Italy, so probably. So here's the picture, ready?
Yeah.
All right, so look at that picture. Isn't that awesome?
Wow, that is an Italian family.
Look at the top. Carlo and Luigia Gallo, and yes, I am a Gallo descendant.
Yeah.
I don't have the Gallo money, but I got Gallo wine.
I do love that. I mean, there's something to that.
That's my great-grandfather and great-grandmother. Great-great. Sorry, that's great-great?
Great-great.
Great-great. And the dude in the middle...
Who's glowing?
Yeah, he's third from the right. Third from the right. That is Vincent, and Vincent is my great-grandfather.
Wow.
And he had my... he got married and had my grandfather, Dante, and my father, Paul. So there you go. Down the line.
Down the line, Italian love.
Carrying a great tradition of Italian family, 100%, 50%. 50% of 100, oh no, 100% of 50%. Anyway, we should start cooking, because this takes
start
a little
cooking,
bit.
Start cooking, come
on. All right, so what I'm going to do today is we're going to make
hungry.
A mic. You're always hungry.
I'm always hungry.
I know. We're going to make a micro bolognese. So typically when I do this, and the recipe that you guys see online is the big version, you know, 3 pounds of meat and all the accoutrements, which is French. It's French. I don't mean to throw out French on here. I know French quite
so
well.
So confused.
Oui. But I'm going to do a micro bolognese so it cooks a lot faster for our little show here. And we got something new to show you guys. We have a cooking cam. So let's start there. You want me to put on the cooking cam?
I'd like you to put on the cooking cam.
All right, so we can do the beginning part. Can you heat the pan for me there?
I could hook up the pan.
Everybody watch this. It's going to be cool. Whoa. Check that out. All right, we're here. All right, let's do this.
What? Can you see the wine?
Yep, they sure can.
Whoa. Okay.
All right.
Take over.
Let me do this, all right? So, so what we got here is we just heated up the pan. First, we're going to get some of our ingredients in there, all right, which is our veggies. And I love that Italians put veggie in bolognese because I think we just do it just to make ourselves feel better. There's really no benefit to this at all.
Okay, that's unfiltered olive oil for
unfiltered
those of you who are geeky like the husband is.
And a little butter.
Oh!
maybe a little easier next time. I'm going to turn that up so it really gets going. So you want a
easy
little bit of
on
onions.
The butter.
No, don't put your hair in the don't put your hair in the flame, you goof. You can't have your head explode.
Come on.
You just put your hand in the flame. You can't do that. You can't put your head in the flame.
I can.
No. Alright, so
this is rock and roll day.
A little bit of onion, right? We get that going until translucent. And I think I taught you guys this before, the garlic, right? So you cut the ends off. This is kind of the magic way of doing it.
Right.
Right? And you get that little skin. It's always a pain in the ass to get off.
Yeah.
Flat side of the knife.
Oh!
Oh! And that little skin comes right off. Super, super easy like that.
Wow.
Right? And then I like to...
I never watched you do that. That's cool.
Instead of cutting it up, I like to just squish it because it gets a little bit more flavor in there. You get the more garlic. The amount of garlic you want to put in here is proportionate to how much you love garlic, which for me is a lot. But when you squish it like that, it really comes out a lot.
If we're both eating it, we can cancel each other out.
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
All right, so let's get that going and get a little translucent. Get that butter, so you get that buttery flavor. You get the olive oil, so you get that olive oily flavor, unfiltered. Is olive oily work?
No, but you know what? It smells so good. I'm going to let that pass.
All right, let's start our water up over here, too, so when we throw our fresh pasta in,
oh my God,
we can get that going.
Yeah.
All right, so you want to wait a little longer to get that translucent, but I'm going to move this along. We're going to get a little carrot, and the reason you put carrot in it, a little color, again, so Italians feel like they're actually getting some veggies in this. You can see it in the bowl.
It's good for the eyes.
It's good for the eyes. And a little sweetness. Actually, carrots do have, they're some of the higher sugar veggies.
My grandmother said the more celery you put in something, the better it'll be.
Yeah, I don't know why, because celery doesn't really have flavor, I don't know.
She believed it, and she was
All right.
Big woman. She knew her food.
How big was your grandma?
Big. She's an opera singer.
Oh, yeah?
You know, they say, you know, that opera singers, you know, little girth never hurt anyone.
Right.
You know?
Right. Okay. So we got this going here, guys.
Yeah.
And then, once this kind of reduces down a little bit, we're going to move this along pretty quickly, but once this reduces down a little bit, we're going to put the meat in. So while that's working there, I'm going to show you the types of meat. Now, this is the awesome way, the awesomeness, awesome way. So, we got three types of meat here on the cam. Got it. First one is pork. And that could be, sausage.
Pork sausage?
Yep. And I don't get the Italian spiced one. I get it straight up. It's basically sausage, you know? And I love to get it ground. And what sausage adds to it is a little saltiness and a little bit of saltiness. The next thing is beef. Now, beef gives you kind of the brawn and the meaty part of the bolognese, because I love my bolognese is meaty.
Yeah, yeah.
And the final one is a veal, the ground veal. The ground veal. And I love veal because it gives you that kind of creaminess along with the meat flavor.
Right.
So veal is awesome to add into. Okay?
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in, and you want to kind of...
Smells
like,
so good.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. We're going to move everybody back to the other camera here in a second. So Mindy's going to play a song while I do the meat part. And that's the veal. Break it up in there.
Wait, this is the micro?
This is micro.
Micro. Right?
This is all just a third a pound I'm putting in now, which seems like a lot. Normally, it's a whole pound of each.
Of each. 3 pounds of meat. That's a
three
lot.
3 pounds of meat, usually in a much bigger bowl.
Wow.
All right?
All right. I'm going to take over.
All right, you do that, and I'm going to move the camera back so people can see you, and Mindy's going to play a little song while I get the food going.
It's kind of cool. Different colors of meat, different colors of veggies. I like this.
All right, let me get the camera back. How's everybody doing out there? Let us know if everything's good, if you're seeing everything fine. Oh, there you are. They can see you on camera.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Check me out.
Woo!
I'm making it happen over here with the beef.
Don't cut it too thin.
Sausage.
Uh-oh. Hey, listen, I just got a little calling from Laura Matlock for Food Network.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yep, yep. Mindy's got an agent, Laura, but I have an agent as well. the cooking cam is going over well.
I don't know that we're ever going to need an agent for our cooking. We just do this because it's fun.
Yeah.
There are other people who are, really awesome at this. We just like goofing with you guys and having a good time.
Cece Schwartz said we got to get the smell-o-vision going. So,
My God. If you could smell this, it's amazing.
All right.
It's amazing.
All right, so let me work on the bolognese. If you play a nice song for the nice people, how about that?
Okay. I'm sweating over here.
That's right.
But I'm I'm breathing it in. It's amazing.
Let me get all right. There's you, veal on the ground.
There's butter on the ground. There's veal. All right. While he cooks his meat, I'm going to play you a song. And
Wait, what?
I'm going to play you some Rolling Stones because, you know, we got the news of Charlie Watts passing today. I'm always a Rolling Stones fan. They had one of the best sax players on the planet, Bobby Keys, playing for them. They're amazing. And look, our wine today that we're pairing all this with, the excuse for us making bolognese is Vive la Rock.
Vive la Rock.
Right?
Vive la Rock.
Whole playlist that I came up with.
Hey, by the way, it's not very Italian. It's French again.
All right, look. We do as good as we can do. It's fine. The wine is spectacular. And for our club members, you're going to get this in a couple days. It ships tomorrow, and you're going to absolutely love it. But you have to listen.
And you're going
to
like it.
While you drink, because the playlist is spectacular. And you know what? It's rock and roll. And there's this abandon to rock and roll. It's amazing. So, check this out. But I'm going to play you some Rolling Stones, because that is on the playlist that you'll get with this wine. And it's appropriate for today. So.
One thing I'm going to ask our people out there. So, please let me know when Mindy plays if the mics are either too blown out or okay. Because I'm not over by the computer.
I'm loud?
No,
is that
no,
what
no,
you're,
no.
You're saying the saxophone?
You're the quietest person to go through a pandemic with.
No, don't.
Blinking twice.
No. All right, all you Rolling Stones fans, put your glasses in the air.
Woo!
And sniff the bolognese that's on your
Just don't
stove.
Burn your hair off.
It's fine.
I mean,
why is he so, he's so protective?
I like that our cooking show has a little danger to it, like you might actually combust.
Danger is a part of rock and roll. Are we right? Have we seen dangerous things happen in rock and roll?
Hey,
girls on the top of cars.
Easy up there, jazz artists.
You know.
Easy jazz
artists. Pyrotechnics and, you know.
Easy jazz artists.
Hey, get toured with Aerosmith. I can talk about these things.
Oh, Rosemary, it's actually Batman, not Superman. But Superman's always nearby.
True. True. Superman is Jerry Seinfeld. Batman is us.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Little Rolling Stones.
Do it!
Thank you.
to cooking. Nice song.
What's going on?
Well, we got to get the tomatoes.
Oh, tomatoes.
And the milk in. So everybody's having a good time right now.
Is that the cutest little milk carton that you've ever seen? Not carton, but milk.
So this is something that not a lot of people know.
Why would milk go in a bolognese?
So when you eat a lot of meat, you guys know, meat is highly acidic. And this is something that I learned kind of along the way. I'm sure I learned it in childhood, somewhere along the way from my mom or dad. But we used to put, and we do put, a little bit of milk in the meat to balance out the acidity. Meat is very acidic, and you want to get that kind of buttery texture to your bolognese. So, and it's the cutest milk on the planet.
See so that? Cute!
So you want to get the milkiest milk that you have. And typically I put a whole cup in for the big amount, but on this we're going to do a little less. So actually, let me do the cam again.
You said milkiest milk?
Yeah, yeah.
But what does that mean? Is this...
It's more milky than milk.
Is this skim milk? Is this...
Is this
whole milk?
In California, we typically do skim, soy. We do almond avocado derivative with
almond
milk chaser.
Just
but this is 100% whole milk
organic.
We used to choose the organic.
And how much is going in there?
Well, on our micro bolognese, I try to put about enough to kind of coat it just a little bit. I said, if you're doing the whole big bolognese, you probably want to put more in to coat it, cover it, and then let it reduce down.
Okay.
But since we're doing a little faster version,
Did you put the...
This makes a huge difference, by the way. Huge difference.
Did you put the recipe on our invite?
Yep.
Oh, cool. So you've got it. That's awesome.
Yep. So you guys can see that the milk, and you can see the meat is actually getting a little creamy, and this is a brilliant thing to do for bolognese. If you don't do this, definitely do it. So this adds, this is all texture. If you don't do this, definitely do it. Does that make sense?
No, you're showing him something, you're showing him like a trick.
Yeah, I'm showing him a trick. Hey, just do it, all right?
Didn't your dad do this? Your dad was a chef.
Yeah, my dad was a chef for many, many years, yeah. For all you Jersey people out there, my dad was a chef at the Rockaway Country Club growing up. An awesome Italian kitchen there, all right?
See?
All right, so usually we're going to let this reduce down a little bit more, but what I'm going to do is the next step, which is add the wine. So so the milk gives you that texture, right? And the wine, you want to add red wine because I love the color. The red wine gives you more of a pop to the color, gives you a little burgundy. And look at that.
That's
add the red wine right in there. The alcohol gives you flavor. The wine gives you flavor. To me, you want to use a rich, dense wine. Chiantis, Riojas, anything that's kind of a bigger red wine. So you can add as much flavor into this bolognese as possible. Now you want to bring it up to a boil. And then we're going to reduce it down. And then we'll go on to the next step. So I'm going to put you back on camera. Okay?
Okay. I'm gonna stir and I'm gonna breathe it in.
All right.
This is the best facial, girls. You're looking for something for your skin? Don't go to the facialist. Don't go to the spa. Have your husband make you bolognese and just stick your face in it. It's awesome. Super awesome. I'm just getting a light steam. I look moisturized.
All right. So how much milk? So Paula, to me, it's just the amount of milk you put in is just comes up to the amount of meat that is in it. So if you're doing the 3-pound recipe, then it's a cup of milk. I'm doing a third a pound, so it's about a third to a half a cup. It all really depends on how much meat you got in there.
He kind of eyeballs it. I watch him cook. I'm always like, ooh, it's a cup. It's whatever. But I know you did figure it out, and he put it in our... You know, in our event, in our invite, the actual amount.
Yeah.
But I think it makes a difference. He put amazing milk in there. I mean, that milk that he put in is crazy great, and the meat we got is crazy great too. So.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to talk about the wine for a second though, because this is so special.
Hey, where's the little?
Not only the artwork and the music playlist, but the wine is amazing. So to all of our members for reserve tastings. You're getting this in a couple days. You're going to absolutely love it. To those of you who don't know, we have a wine and music company, and that doesn't mean we have other people's wines that we sell you. That's not it. Eric finds all these amazing wines that no one else can get. You can't get them anywhere else, and they're pretty unbelievable. I take them. I put incredible artwork with them. Some of my friends do the artwork. Our daughter's done the artwork.
Yeah.
We've done some of the artwork, but art is as important as all of it.
Yeah.
It's all music and art and the wine. And of course, I put a playlist with every wine. So we want you to join our club. It's reservetastings.com, and you'll get wine from us four times a year.
So,
and you can decide how much.
And to all our members out there, Mindy was mentioning, I know a lot of you guys are here. You guys bought almost everything that we have.
Oh, my God.
So the just so you guys know, the rosé watch, Flower Child, gone.
I have a little tear in my eye because of that, but...
Rosé is gone. We got a couple.
I have one bottle left.
One bottle left. Woo! You guys are getting all the rest. You guys,
I left it.
You guys
me.
Bought cases of this, and it's going all around the country. The Viognier, Notes Viognier.
I know.
Gone.
That was a beautiful playlist, too. That was Baroque music. It was amazing.
And grab the Zin bottle right there. You guys bought the last of the Dry Creek Zinfandel. And all the Zinfandel. Gone. Gone.
It's called the Theory of Joy. And
Theory
I had fun on this label.
Yeah.
But of course, I kept two for us. So maybe that's what we drink next. We'll
see. Yeah, maybe. I think we're going to go through the cab. And so all we have left is the two wines, the Sauvignon Blanc from Rutherford, which I think is going to be one of our most popular wines. You guys all love Cabernet. We got this big Paso Robles Cabernet. We're going to do a Zoom call with all our members. And we have a little bit of the Monterey Pinot Noir left. But after that, done.
Viva la Sol Pinot Noir. That's my favorite. It's this unfiltered wine.
And you guys drink a lot.
So become a member if you're not. I know so many of our members are online right now and having fun with us.
Yeah.
I hope you're making the Bolognese because it's pairing unbelievably with this Cabernet.
Okay.
And it's so fun. You are going to love this wine, and I just can't wait for you to get it.
Going back to the cooking cam real quick. So just to show everybody, you notice how the wine is reduced down, the milk is reduced down, and that meat has a lot more flavor now. So don't put your hair in the fire. No. No. Back away from the flame. No. 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 Yeah.
Just a little more.
Hey. Who's the chef?
Hi.
Everybody, she's going to burn her hair soon. Mindy's going to be on tour with Dave Koz with a new hairstyle.
Peace. Short hair. Short hair's in.
Short
you know,
hair's
I
in,
could
yeah.
do that. It'd be fine.
All right, so...
Oh, it needs to reduce down. You're so right.
Everybody's
right?
getting the news right now that the rosé is gone. It's like, no.
No.
Oh, Alan Thompson's showing off. He's like, yeah, I bought the last bit.
Did you buy it, Alan? You were the one that bought it. Oh,
yeah,
my God.
Cut that up. Alan's, you know.
Hey, cheers. R.I.P. to our rosé, but it went into good hands, and, you know, it is what it is. All right, can I play another song?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, it's cooking. It's doing its thing. What are you guys doing? You're just drinking, right?
Yep.
We could play music. I'm just saying. The song that I was thinking of doing for you guys, I'm looking here because I've got it on a playlist.
What are you doing?
I'm looking over here at my playlist.
Right.
So, the song that I'm thinking of doing, look, I've loved rock and roll my whole life. I grew up with it. This guy, you know, grew up in Jersey listening to Bruce Springsteen all the time, going to his concerts. Are you eating back there?
No.
See, it happens.
I got one of the sausages.
Yeah?
Go ahead.
Yeah, see? Okay, see?
Milky, alcoholic.
I've got the wine,
alcoholic-y.
Though. I win.
Yeah. It's almost getting to like a gravy level. You guys go ahead and just listen to her. I got a moment here. This
oh
is
my
the
God.
Beef right here.
Pay no attention. He's going nuts back there.
Mm.
This is, yeah. Okay, so I loved watching MTV. I loved watching rock bands. My first concert that I paid for was Cheap Trick. I love this. So I got to tour with rock bands. I got to play with Springsteen for a night. I got to play with Aerosmith for a summer. I took my summer vacation with Aerosmith on their global warming tour. So the one thing I can say about rock and roll and this wine, it's called Viva La Rock for a reason. Rock and roll is all about abandon. Rock and roll is letting it all hang out, giving it your all, just going with your gut. There's no control of it. There's even no thought process, you know? Sometimes you just have to go with it. When I first started playing in Adam Sandler's band, it was all rockers. It was Waddy Wachtel from you know, Linda Ronstadt and Bob Seger, and, you know, these guys were like, stop thinking and start emoting and just give us what's in your mind. So I got to do a song for my Wild Heart record. Joe Perry was good enough to come in and play with me, and it was just such an incredible moment. And this guy lives, breathes, eats, is rock and roll, and I had so much fun playing with him. So the song that we did is called Kick Ass. Kick Ass. It's all right to say. You can say it. Mm-hmm. And so I want to play it for you.
I got a question.
Mm-hmm.
I got an important question.
Eric.
Did you have, like, a cappuccino or something? You're really chatty today.
No.
I mean, chatty in a really attractive, sexy, fun way.
Like, how sexy and fun?
It's really...
Do you have bolognese all over your shirt? Because that's super sexy.
I love this shirt. Will this come out?
Maybe.
I'm going to take my shirt off.
I don't know. Let me try and get it out with the wine.
No! Shirt.
Okay, he's going to go clean his shirt. Now I'm going to play you some Kick Ass.
I love this shirt.
Oh, I do too. You look fantastic in it. Are you going to go shirtless?
No, I got to.
That's a whole different show, though.
No.
I'm fine with it.
All right.
Good. All right. Solo. Go listen to Wild Heart. My record, Wild Heart. Featuring Joe Perry.
Yay.
That's a little rock and roll for you.
Yay.
Her kitchen got very loud. Did you change your shirt?
No. I like that shirt. But I figured I'd pick a food theme. It has nothing to do with bolognese, but I love peanut butter.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I've got my jelly shirt.
You can go put it on if you want.
Wow, really?
Yeah. I'm going to get back to our little cooking here.
Okay, good. Get back.
All right, I want to get the sauce in. All right, everybody's been so patient, doing such a great job. We're going to go back to the food cam. The Mevo can.
What?
Woo! Look at that.
I'm going to drink his wine.
Yep. No. No. Okay, let me get in here.
Yay!
Yay! Okay. All right, let us know if you guys, if you can't hear us. I know last time we walked over here you couldn't hear too well, so I just turned the mic back up. So you can see we kind of reduced this down. And like I said, normally this is a hour or 2 hour process just to get all the milk and the wine all reduced down and concentrated. But that's a beautiful thing right there. You got your little carrots you can see in there. Everything looks fantastic. So the next thing is putting the tomato paste in it and the tomato sauce. Now, I mentioned this to you guys before. This is super important. I'm going to move the camera back so you can see this. I've had a couple people try this, and it is a game changer. This is a game-changing moment. Game-changing moment. So this, let me make sure I got it on the camera. This is not just tomato sauce. It is very important, you guys, buy San Marzano. And there's two types of San Marzano. There's the real kind, and then there's everything else they call San Marzano, but it's not really from this region of Italy. So there's San Marzano, and you can see that they're very concentrated, very sweet, very flavorful, and lots of color. But you want to get it DOP. You actually have a regulation on this type of tomato in Italy. It's hard to find. So it's called the Pomodoro San Marzano, and it comes from the Sarnese Nocerino region of this area, which is right outside of Naples, and DOP. It's a game changer on all things. Marinara, bolognese, whatever you use tomato sauce for, go with this. It's unbelievable. Right, Mindy? I mean, you could definitely tell the difference.
Always marry a man with good taste in tomatoes.
Did you change shirt?
No. Okay, yeah, I did.
Did you change?
I changed my shirt.
Salt and pepper.
Because it's not jelly. Salt and pepper, it's peanut butter and jelly.
Yeah, I forgot that.
It's not salt and pepper. What? That's another band.
Wait, they're not on camera anymore. Yay! All right, so we learned about the tomatoes, so let's get them in. Oh, I don't want to mess up the shirt.
You're going to mess up your peanut butter shirt.
All right, so normally I would cut the whole can in. But I don't know if I'm putting the whole can on this one. I'm going to feel it out here.
Oh, you are feeling it out.
Literally and figuratively feeling out how much tomatoes we should put in here.
Okay.
So you want to crush them, even though they'll kind of crush down on their own.
Okay.
Can you turn the heat up on this, please?
Yeah.
I turned it way too down. You want to crank it all the way.
Okay, I'm cranking.
Yeah, because we're doing this fast. A little less five. There you go.
Okay, not quite
cranked. All right, grab the spatula thing and mix it around so we can see how much is in there. Now, I don't like a ton of tomato sauce on my bolognese.
I do.
I know. I like to get it in there, make it beautiful, make it colorful, get that tomato flavor.
Yeah, yeah.
Without getting it too watery. You don't want a watery bolognese.
Okay. Should we add more wine?
No, that ship has sailed.
Okay, fine.
You guys can see how it's getting integrated in there now really beautifully. And look at that tomato right there. That's just a concentrated little pomodoro tomato. There you go.
And your shirt is still intact.
Yeah, I know. I'm doing it pretty good.
What?
There you go.
See, you almost added that whole can.
Almost. I was feeling it out. And then the other thing is you want to add a little tomato paste. And I love paste because it adds a little density. And like I said, I don't like my bolognese runny, so it also makes it a little bit kind of thicker.
You are my density.
So this is, you are my density. this is Mutti from Parma, which is northern Italy. And I love these little concentrated tubes. Ready?
Oh.
Oh.
Don't.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Really?
Oh.
Oh my God.
Yay! Mutti tomato paste. It's like a commercial.
Mutti tomato paste. Oh my God, it's all over the thing.
Wait, let's do a...
It went everywhere.
Oh, did it?
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
It's all right.
Let's do a Mutti commercial. Ready? Want to do a Mutti commercial?
Sure.
Okay,
yeah.
I'm going to put it back in the other cam. Ready?
Oh, yeah. Oh, it looks so good.
Ready?
It's so good. Okay.
Hey, Mindy.
Hi, honey.
Wait, is this supposed to be Italian, though?
Oh, I don't know.
Hey, Mindy.
Yes.
Right. Hey, Mindy. I know that you're making bolognese tonight, and I was just hoping that it was condensed and concentrated with a little bit of tomato paste.
Do you think my bolognese would be better with your tomato paste?
This is getting really creepy suggestive, isn't it?
Yes,
and it's called Mutti. Mutti, the tomato paste of the bolognese of awesomeness.
Wow. Ah, thank you.
Ding. And see.
Wow. Okay, so us moving back to Hollywood, maybe this hasn't been great for, you know, the cooking shows of
fans.
You know,
yes, thank you.
Out.
You guys can't see outside right now. There's tons of thousands of people out there.
No, those are the
awesome.
Police cars and the helicopters going after other people.
All right, so one thing you want to do at this point, too, is we want to put a little salt and a little pepper. And we're kind of coming down to the end of our bolognese here. We did a fast version, which is just beautiful.
Can I hold it up? Because you got to see this.
We have the can.
Oh. But I had these
We don't
already.
Have to hold it up anymore. Like the old days, we used to have to hold it up.
I'm so used to... Okay.
Sorry, I didn't mean to crush
but
your...
What do I do with these now?
We have the bolognese can.
Okay.
So
I feel lost. I'm... Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah?
Well, you tell me.
Okay. Well, we have to posture.
Yeah, I know.
Wait.
Well, I'm eating. You want?
Are you supposed to feed me, right? I mean, this is like,
hey!
What are you doing? You're married.
Hey!
I'm getting all jersey on you.
What do you got doing here? Just take the freaking bolognese. I sound like Vinnie Barbarino. 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 You got me shaking and rocking.
I'm the one who had a cappuccino.
What show was that?
Welcome back, Cotter.
Welcome back. Welcome back. How's that
really
sound?
Really good. Wait.
You're teasing a lot. Welcome back.
Can I put the pasta in?
No, not yet.
Yeah, I gotta do what he says. He's the chef tonight. But can I just say we went to Italy. Not Italy. We went to Italy, and we bought pasta. Love this.
Welcome back. Your dreams are your ticket out.
Who knows the words? Go ahead.
Same old place you dreamed about. And the names all changed when you come around.
Making the words up.
Have remained.
And you turn around. Ready?
Who they thought they need ya? Who they thought they need ya? We're where we need ya. Well, it's a lot, but we got it on spot. Welcome back.
How did we get on Mr. Potter?
I was doing Vinnie Barbarino.
I don't know the second verse. I was like, wait, it was rock and roll night.
Da, 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 da. All right.
I've got my own Vinnie Barbarino.
Hey!
Hey,
go F yourself. What do you put that on the stove? You're going to put the house on fire.
I love to like put him on the edge because he's safety oriented. So anything
right.
I can do to keep him on the edge. It's good. It keeps me happy.
One thing I forgot to put in to give it a little bit of earthiness and a little greenness is our bay leaf. Forgot the bay leaf. So let's put the bay leaf in.
The bay leaf should have gone in early, right?
Yeah, I was singing Welcome Back, Cotter.
Yeah.
And I love that the bay leaf is this kind of subtle flavor that just permeates throughout the entire sauce.
Oh my God, it smells so good. Can I cook the pasta yet?
Yeah, well, we're going to get the water boiling. So you want to show them the pasta real quick?
Yeah.
You can go to the camera with that one if you want, because you seem to want to do that, so.
Well, I'm interested in the pasta. Very food driven.
All right.
But check this out, a little fresh pasta. And I didn't have to make it. He didn't have to make it. We just bought it, and it's from Italy, and it's awesome. So it takes 2 minutes to cook. I mean, if that, right?
What?
The pasta.
Yeah.
So, because it's fresh. So, yeah. So.
I'm like, what are you talking about?
Here's the pasta.
Yay.
It's going to go in.
Hey, are your hands clean after the touching the saxophone?
No. Here, I'm going to touch the pasta so that only I can eat it.
All right, I'm going to do the overhead cam so they can see the pasta go in. It'll cook very, very quick, everybody. Fresh pasta. You got to use fresh pasta every time. I didn't salt the water peanut.
What?
What?
No, you're peanut butter. I'm jelly.
Oh, jelly. I didn't salt the butter.
You didn't salt the butter?
I mean, I didn't salt the water.
Okay.
Oh, I'm exhausted.
All right.
And you guys can see that bolognese, how it's reducing down. Again, I'm cooking it a lot faster than we normally. Literally, it usually takes 5 hours, so we're doing an accelerated version here. If you really want that sauce to permeate the meat, then that's the best way to do it over a longer period of time. But
some of this.
Even quick, the micro bolognese is going very fast, and it looks absolutely beautiful.
Got the pasta going.
Hey!
All
right, what do you want to do while I'm finishing this up?
Okay, so while he's finishing this up, I want to tell you that you want to go to Italy with us. Not Italy. We went to Italy to get the pasta. We're going to Italy. Yep. And we're going to Italy in November. So it's November 1st through 5th, and we're going as part of our club, Reserve Tastings, but we're taking all of you guys. We're about 75% sold out, so there's only a couple of places left, but we'd love you to come with us. And you know what? The world seems to be our oyster right now, so we're going for it. We're going to be safe. There's protocols in place. Don't get us wrong. But we want to go drink wine and eat incredible food. So we're going to stay at a 5-star resort in Siena. And it looks like a castle. It's amazing. And we're going to go on wine tastings and eat amazing food. Go to a pecorino farm. Just have fun. I'm going to play every night with friends. And we're going to make music, drink, and eat, and have a blast. So go to reservetastings.com if you haven't signed up and you want to go to Italy with, 35, 40 of your closest friends and just hang out.
Well, Italy as well as Sonoma, too. So I got them up on the screen. So you got Italy right there, and you got Sonoma.
Sonoma, you know, it seems like a long way away, but it's not. April 2022, it's coming up so quickly. It's amazing.
Sorry. This is the Italy one real quick, everybody, and that's the hotel on the right there.
Ah,
the
amazing.
Grand Hotel Continental, yeah. All right, sorry, let's go back to Sonoma. So no, Sonoma is going to come up here quick, April. We did one already, and it was so popular, we added another.
Well, we added it immediately, and it was so fun, and it was almost sold out. So I think there's only a couple more spots for Sonoma. But we want you to come with us. We had such a great time the first time. We made such incredible friends. That was the thing I didn't even think about. It was just an incredible, incredible experience.
You're still on screen, but take a look at the right here. That's where Hotel Healdsburg is. That's where we'll be staying.
It's amazing.
And that's a picture in the middle there of Mindy playing with Ashling, right?
Yeah, Ashling Cole.
Yeah.
We were out at McCrossy Winery, and then we went to Coppola Winery, and Rick Braun, and myself.
There's some pictures from the
yeah. Oh yeah, you're showing a bunch of stuff. We had so much fun, so we want you to join us there too, and just have fun with us. Or, you know, you can make some bolognese at home with us, because we love doing this too. But we want to invite you to all of our fun things.
Are we finishing this up?
This is his new hat, and Eric's going to wear this soon. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, but I got a product in my hair. I probably won't make the bolognese.
But I'm going to ask the Italian husband, is this pasta done?
Excuse me. Let the expert through. I am, 100% of 50% Italian.
And that, I'm remembering.
And by the way, that gives me a 50-50 chance of getting this right. That doesn't make any sense. Oh, it's hot if you take it out of the water. No.
It's not ready.
You want to play a little bit more?
I can play a little more for the nice people.
Play one more quick song and then we'll finish it up.
Okay, do you... we haven't even showed them the playlist. The playlist for our Cabernet Sauvignon is awesome.
Kind of tell them how I'll show it on the screen. Tell them how we do the whole thing.
Okay, so when you get the wine for our club members who don't know, or just, those of you who are looking on Spotify, we have Spotify playlists for every one of our wines. So you can go, you get your, really? Oh my God, it just keeps eating. These, you're not.
I'm so full.
Oh my God, wait, I haven't eaten anything. That's not fair. That's not the way this is going. So every wine has a playlist, and this one is so cool. So, you gotta drink it, you gotta listen, and it's so fun to listen. So for me, I love my rock and roll. So it's, you know, this wine is strong. It's got a lot of power to it. And so the rock and roll goes perfectly. My friend Nick Egan did the artwork for any of you guys interested. I know he has prints of this. He also has prints of, say you wanna be a rock star. You want to be a rock and roll star?
Can I show them
on our wall.
Can I show them the Spotify?
Yeah, show them the Spotify playlist.
All right, so this is what you guys need to do. Come to our page, right? Our Reserve Tastings page. Just type in Reserve Tastings in Spotify. And we have this page here with all these playlists. And you guys notice the playlists are our labels, right? So it's easy to say, okay, I'm drinking Viva La Rock tonight. I click on it, and there is the playlist. And you start playing it. So, like, the first song, right?
Oh, yeah! Woo!
Drinking your rock.
It's rock and roll!
Oh, yeah, baby.
Come on! Aerosmith in the house!
That's a great, great, no, this is pretty appropriate. How about this one? All right.
Whoa. It's very appropriate, right?
So our bolognese is reduced down tremendously right now. That's awesome. Wow. Very condensed. Very dense. All right, so I think our pasta is ready.
Okay.
We had to cook it a little bit longer than I anticipated, but it's all by feel, right? So let's go over by the sink.
Right.
Let me do this so I don't burn you. You gotta work. Look at that. Get all the water out. Get all that water out. You want to get a little plate for us, and we'll plate this, and I think we're just about wrapping up. There you go. Alright, you ready? Wait, I'll get a free one. I'm gonna get this pasta up the stove.
Ow! Ow! See? It's like the song. Okay, are you ready? You're not ready for this. You've already eaten it all.
Yeah, I'm so full. Hey, go ahead.
Woo!
Damn. Damn! Got one little bit of one bit.
Woo!
Here we go, ready?
Put another dime in the jukebox, baby.
So this is grana panana, which is very much like Parmigiano Reggiano. So you could use either. They both have very same kind of feel to them and taste to them. And that is Eric's awesome bolognese of awesomeness.
Try
it.
I love rock and roll.
Yeah. Dance with me. Here you go, Jen.
Do I need
the pasta?
I don't know. I
kind of
do.
It looks damn good.
Dance with me.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Really good.
Very nice.
Woo-hoo. I wish you were here eating this with me. I know he's eaten a bunch of it. It's so good. It's tomatoey. It's rock and roll.
Oh, turn the burner off.
It's Italian.
Thanks, Carl.
I mean...
we have people out there taking care of our safety. Thanks, Carl.
Whatever. I'm busy, Carl.
Nick said it too. Turn the burner off.
I'm eating. It's so good. I shouldn't have the bay leaf in here. Maybe we should get rid of that, but hey... Bye-bye. But I'm going
to
eat
this. Oh, I've got to take the bay leaf.
And we're going to have such a good time with our bolognese.
Can I have a little bite of the bolognese?
You have eaten most of it.
Bolognese.
All right, fine. Okay, just the bolognese. I know you want, like,
just
the meaty meat.
I could even see it in there, too. The lighter veal. I could see it floating around. The concentration of the flavors. Mmm. Mmm.
I think the milk does something. You just don't know it's in there, but it's special.
Adds that creaminess to the meat. Yeah. So, hopefully you guys loved it tonight. Hopefully you guys had fun as we did. Like we say, we're not chefs. We're far from it. We just like to cook at home and share it with you guys. And I don't know when we'll be back online. Mindy's going to be working a lot, so we'll just keep looking out. We're going to do our back porch shows. We'll throw in a cooking show. Maybe we'll do it on the road.
Who knows?
Santa Barbara.
Right?
Anybody coming to Napa with us this weekend?
Yeah. We're going to have fun. We're out on the road. Go to MindyAbear.com.
San Diego Sunday.
Oh, yeah.
Monday?
San Diego, Temecula. Yeah. We are going...
I forget where we're going.
Everywhere. So go to my website. Get tickets. I'm doing a lot with Summer Horns, with Dave Cause and Vincent Ingala and Kirk Whalum. It's just an incredible show. Kenny Lattimore is coming in for some of them as well.
Yeah.
And then I'm going out with my band for a few dates as well. And at the end of the year, I'm going out with Peter White and Vincent Ingala for our Christmas show again.
Pedro Blanco, after we go to Italy.
After we go to Italy. So. But for now, I've got his bolognese to keep me happy.
And if you're interested in our wine, come to our website. Join our membership because we're running out of wine. All our members are awesome. Thank you very much.
We love you guys.
Anything you guys need from us next week with all the club orders, you can let us know. Love you. I love you.
Cheers. Ooh, so good.